हेलो फ्रेंड्स, सो दिस वीडियो इज़ इन कॉन्टिन्यूशन विद द बोनी कट्स इन अ टोटल नी रिप्लेसमेंट वीडियो। हेयर इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द एंटीरियर वर्सेस पोस्टीरियर रेफरेंसिंग इन अ टोटल नी रिप्लेसमेंट। सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस द वेरियस कट्स। सो एंटीरियर रेफरेंसिंग एंड पोस्टीरियर रेफरेंसिंग इज यूज वाइल डूइंग द एंटीरियर एंड द पोस्टीरियर फिमोरल कट्स विच विल अफेक्ट द फ्लेक्शन गैप इन अ टोटल नी रिप्लेसमेंट। So what is the referencing? It is dependent upon the reference point. That is, in case of posterior referencing, we take a posterior reference point. That is, we take a posterior point which is fixed, and the anterior cut is variable depending upon the posterior reference point. And in case of anterior referencing, we take an anterior reference point, anterior fixed point, and a posterior cut here is variable, and it is dependent upon the anterior reference point. So the distal femoral preparation and sizing, they are both important for the overall balancing and the function of a total knee replacement. This anterior cut, it goes through the trochlear groove, and the depth of this cut affects the patellofemoral joint. So this cut, it goes through the patellofemoral. Here is the patella bone lying overly. So this cut will affect the patellofemoral joint. And the posterior cut, it goes through the posterior femoral condyles, and it will affect the flexion gap. So this posterior cut, it goes through the posterior femoral condyle, and this will affect the flexion in a total knee replacement. At the end of the both cuts, the anterior and the posterior cuts, they should be parallel, and together they determine the rotation of the femoral implant. So these are the various references that we can use. So the first one is the wide side line. So this is the line in the center of the trochlea, which is perpendicular to the transepicondylar axis. So we take a medial epicondyle, we take a lateral epicondyle, and line joining them is the transepicondylar axis, which is usually parallel to this tibial cut. Then the third reference point is the posterior condyle reference point. So in the previous video we have discussed that this original native joint line is in 3 degrees of valgus. So while we are taking the posterior condyle as a reference, we have to externally rotate by 3 degrees, so that a cut made is parallel to the straight tibial cut. So this means we get a perfect rectangle and our rotation is correct. So these are the three lines that we can use. One is the wide side line. Then we have the transepicondylar axis. If we are using the transepicondylar axis, we need not to go for the 3 degrees of external rotation. But if we are using for the posterior condylar referencing, we need to go for the 3 degrees of the external rotation to compensate for the 3 degrees of the valgus in a native joint line. So this will affect our rotation of the implant. So these are the three referencing points for the rotation of the implant. Now talking about the posterior referencing first. So here in case of a posterior referencing jig, we have a two legs that sits over the posterior condyles. So they sit over the posterior condyle and they are fixed there. So this will measure about 9 mm. So we have already discussed the size of the implant. So our thickness of the implant is 9 mm. So the cut made here is fixed, which is 9 mm. So this 9 mm matches the 9 mm from the distal femur cut. Obviously we have made this cut also 9 mm distal femur cut, and we have made the posterior femur cut here as a 9 mm. Because our thickness of the implant is 9 mm. Then we go for these two holes. So these two holes will determine the rotation of the jig. So for determining these two holes, we can use any axis. These three axes can be used, these three references can be used for the rotation part. If we will be using the posterior condyle for the rotation, we will go for a 3 degrees of rotation. But if we'll be using the two condyles, we will go for the straight line, no 3 degrees of rotation. Also, it is important that in case of a posterior referencing, because our distal, this posterior cut is fixed, so our anterior cut is variable. So if our femur is too small, then we will end up overstuffing the patella, because in case of small femur, we will cut less of the femur. So this will cause a overstuffing of patella. But if the femur is too big, then our jig will end up being a small. So this will cut more of the femur and we will end up notching of the implant will occur. So the anterior cut, it is based on the jig size, and if the femur is variably very too small or it is too big, we will end up with these problems in case of a posterior referencing. Now posterior referencing, at the same time we should discuss the posterior condylar offset. So the posterior condylar offset is the amount of the bone that is removed from the posterior condyle. So posterior condylar offset is important because it is directly related to the arc of the motion before impingement. So this amount of bone removed will determine our flexion in case of a total knee replacement. So reduced offset, if a less amount of bone will be removed, it will shift the posterior femoral cortex closer to the posterior tibia and impingement with the tibia will occur, and this will result in a decrease in the knee flexion. So if a less amount of bone is removed, this offset is less, then it will cause impingement and decreases the knee flexion. Now talking about the anterior referencing, so here we use a fixed point which is anterior and our posterior cut is variable. So this technique is opposite to the posterior referencing, whereby we will measure the depth of the anterior cut by a boom and fix it that sits on the anterior cortex. The benefit of this technique is that all the complication of the anterior femoral cortex, that is notching and overstuffing, will not be here because we have already fixed the anterior cut. So all the issues in case of a posterior cut like overstuffing of patella and notching will not be there in case of a anterior referencing. But here will be the problem of a posterior femoral condyle offset, because this posterior femoral condyle cut here, it is variable and it depends upon how much the patient femur anatomy, it matches the implant size. If the femur is big, then we will end up removing too much bone posteriorly, which will decrease the posterior condyle offset and may reduce the range of motion. So this is the anterior referencing. It uses a boom which sits on the anterior cortex and we fix it here with the pins. So once our anterior cut is fixed, we take the posterior condylar cut. So if the femur is too big, then we will end up removing large quantity of bone. So this will decrease the posterior offset and we will have to increase the size of the implant. And if the femur matches the cutting side, then we will remove the appropriate posterior bone. If the femur is small, then we'll remove the too little bone and flexion gap will be small relative to the extension gap. So this is about the anterior and the posterior referencing. To summarize them, in case of anterior referencing, we use a boom and we fix the anterior cut. And then we can change the posterior condyle cut. So here the complication will be regarding the size of the posterior condylar cut, and which will affect the posterior condylar offset and will affect the range of motion. Knee flexion will increase or decrease. So we fix the anterior slot and we adjust the posterior slot to match the size. In case of posterior referencing, we fix the posterior point and our anterior cut is variable. So we fix the posterior slot and then adjust the anterior slot. So here the complication will be because of the two complication. If we will cut less, we will end up overstuffing the patella, and if we cut more, we will cause the notching of the anterior femur cortex. So this is about the anterior versus posterior referencing.